One of my very first professional concert engagements, nearly 40 years ago, was with the Lajban Male Voice Choir. So I have long been familiar with the splendid sound of Cornishmen singing in a body. It's therefore a particular pleasure for me to be invited to introduce this recording. The Cornwall Police Choir was formed in 1956 to celebrate, in the following year, the centenary of the formation of the Cornwall County Constabulary. Following its amalgamation into the Devon and Cornwall Constabulary, the county force no longer existed, but the choir continues to wear with pride the buttons and insignia of the former Cornwall County Constabulary. The choir has helped to raise many thousands of pounds for both national and local charities, undertaking concerts over a very wide area that extends far beyond the county boundary. They are indeed happy and willing wanderers. They rehearse each week at St. Austell in mid-Cornwall, involving some members who live at the extremities of the county in round trips of more than 100 miles at their own expense. But as well as their desire to assist worthy causes, perhaps a significant factor in their motivation is, as I've said, the Cornishmen's love of singing, as demonstrated by the many choirs in existence in the old mining areas and fishing villages of the county. What a wonderful way of giving pleasure and helping others by doing something one really enjoys. Their concerts are always very well supported by the public, which indicates the esteem in which they hold their county police choir, and this must surely enhance the relationships between police and public within the various communities. Let's now relax and enjoy the choir and their music. First, in a song by Sir Hugh Robertson, founder of the famous Orpheus Choir of Glasgow. It's called The Old Stone House, and the words are by the poet Walter de la Mare. Musical director Arnold Oates is one of the finest tenors to come from Cornwall. Singing oratorio is his first love, and he has performed the solos with many of the top Cornish choirs. In 1977, he was invited to take over the role of musical director of the choir, and under his leadership, they've gone from strength to strength. The choir members were most keen to include his voice on this recording, and so here he is singing a song far from the world of oratorio, a spirited English folk song arranged by Francis Collinson, Joe the Carrier Lad.
My name is Joe the Carrier Lad, a merry chap am I. I always am contented, be the weather wet or dry. I snap my fingers at the frost, I whistle at the rain. I brave the storm for many a day and will do so again. Oh, crack, crack goes the whip, I whistle and I sing. I sit upon my wagon, I'm as happy as a king. My horse is always willing, and I am never sad. Oh, who could treat a horse more gay than Joe the Carrier Lad? My father was a carrier 20 years ago. To market on a Thursday, almost regular he would go. Sometimes he'd take me with him, particular in the spring. Then up I'd sit upon the box and hear my father sing. Oh, crack, crack goes the whip, I whistle and I sing. I sit upon my wagon, I'm as happy as a king. My horse is always willing, and I am never sad. Oh, who could treat a horse more gay than Joe the Carrier Lad? The girls, they all do smile at me as I go driving past. My horse, he is a beauty as he trots along so fast. For many a mile we've put behind and happy days we've had. There's none that treats a horse more fair than Joe the Carrier Lad. Oh, crack, crack goes the whip, I whistle and I sing. I sit upon my wagon, I'm as happy as a king. My horse is always willing, and I am never sad. Oh, who could treat a horse more gay than Joe the Carrier Lad? I never think of politics or anything so great. I care not for your hybrid talk about the church and state. I act a righteous man to man, and that's what makes me glad. You'll find there beats an honest heart in Joe the Carrier Lad. Oh, crack, crack goes the whip, I whistle and I sing. I sit upon my wagon, I'm as happy as a king. My horse is always willing, and I am never sad. Oh, who could treat a horse more gay than Joe the Carrier Lad?
Now Arnold exchanges his whip for the baton to conduct a group of three choir items. Firstly, the romantic Unchained melody, then that favourite about the banner with a strange device, Upi Dee, and lastly, the lyrical E'en as a Lovely Flower.
Time goes on.
Now Arnold changes the mood with an Irish song as fresh as a May morning, The Garden Where the Praties Grow by Samuel Liddell. Praties, of course, are potatoes, but this cheerful wooing is nonetheless romantic for that.
Been in love, me boys, or have you felt the pain? I'd sooner be in jail myself than be in love again. For the girl I loved was beautiful, I'd have you all to know. For I met her in the garden where the praties grow. She was just the sort of creature, boys, that nature did intend to walk right through the world, my boys, without the Grecian bend. Nor did she wear a chignon, I'd have you all to know. For I met her in the garden where the praties grow. Says Hi, my pretty Kathleen, I'm tired of single life, and if you'll have no objections, I would make you my sweet wife. She answered me right modestly and curtsied fairly low. Sure, you're welcome to the garden where the praties grow. She was just the sort of creature, boys, that nature did intend to walk right through the world, my boys, without the Grecian bend. Nor did she wear a chignon, I'd have ye all to know, for I met her in the garden where the praties grow. Aye, my pretty Kathleen, I hope that you'll agree. She was not like your city girls who say you're making free. She says, I'll ask me parents and tomorrow I'll let you know if you'll meet me in the garden where the praties grow. She was just the sort of creature, boys, that nature did intend to walk right through the world, my boys, without the Grecian bend. Nor did she wear a chignon, I'd have ye all to know, for I met her in the garden and where the praties grow. All the parents, they consented and were blessed with children three, two boys just like their mother and a girl the image of me. And now we're going to train them up the way they ought to grow, to dig in the garden where the praties grow. She was just the sort of creature, boys, that nature did intend to walk right through the world, my boys, without the Grecian bend. Nor did she wear a chignon, I'd have ye all to know, for I met her in the garden where the praties grow.
The choir end the first part of the concert with three contrasting items composed thousands of miles apart. Little Innocent Lamb is a spiritual from the cotton fields of America. Va Pensiero, or Speed Your Journey, is from Verdi's opera Nabucco, or Nebuchadnezzar, and is sung by Hebrew slaves on the banks of the Euphrates, pining for their homeland. And Gwahoddiad is a fine Welsh hymn. I hear thy welcome voice that calls me, Lord, to thee.
Little lamb, little innocent lamb, I'm going to serve God till I die. Little lamb, little innocent lamb, I'm going to serve God till I die. Hypocrite, hypocrite, tell him what he do. I'm going to serve God till I die.
Sit it on you,
sit it on you.
I'm going to serve God till I die.
title of the gospel song with which Arnold and the choir opened the second half. And they want to thank the Salvation Army for kindly allowing them to sing this delightful arrangement of it. Hugh Robertson's arrangement of the spiritual Were You There is one of those moments in a concert when the audience are reluctant to break the spell with their applause, especially after such a moving performance of it as you'll hear in a few minutes.
Were you there when they crucified?
In the 1920s, a play with music by Rutland Boughton called The Immortal Hour was presented in London's West End. It was set in the twilight world of Celtic mythology, and all that survives of it today is one song, beloved by tenors and audiences alike. Arnold sings it for us now, the fairy song.
How beautiful they are, the lordly ones who dwell in the hills, the hollow hills. They have faces like flowers, and their breath is a wind that blows over summer meadows filled with dew. Than shafts of moonshine. They are more fleet than the March wind. They laugh and are glad and are terrible. When their lances shake and glitter, every green reed
I remember.
That, of course, was Memory from Andrew Lloyd Webber's musical Cats, another example of the choir's versatility. And now, another spiritual, Steal Away. And it will be followed by a folk song, Malamoya, sung in the original German, and it's about a shepherd. The group ends with the Cornwall Police Choir echoing the sentiments of the United States Navy in the musical South Pacific. There is nothing like a day. But first, steal away.
Steal away. Steal away.
basket in a cute form.
There is nothing like a day, nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name that is anything like a day. We can love the air we long for the fair and gentle sex. We would like to feel the beating of some arms around our necks. We get hungry as a wolf and when we can get riding hood. What don't we feel? We don't feel good.
Lots of things in life are beautiful, but brother, there is one particular thing that is nothing whatsoever in any way, shape, or form like any other.
There is nothing like a day, nothing in the world. There is nothing you can name that is anything like a day. There are no books like a day, and nothing looks like a day. There are no drinks like a day. Thank you.
That lovely song, The Old Woman, was from Scotland and the pen of Hugh Roberton. And now the choir show where their hearts and loyalties lie with a splendid rendering of Trelawney. The words of the final item, Close Thine Eyes, are attributed to King Charles I, and Ewan Rhys-Davies' music provides a serene finish to a concert of great variety. On behalf of the choir and its musical director, Arnold Oates, may I say, thank you for buying this cassette and helping us to help others.